It's Deb Helfrich, hashtag Redhead She-Hulk, and my co-host, Zanzi. Summing Deb up. The first imperative of any animal is staying alive. In integrated mammals, pretty much everyone besides humans, the first goal is to stay alive. Everything I have ever not been able to accomplish is because I have been busy trying to stay alive by my damn self. Do you want to know why? Fertility is declining in our species? Because we are so unsuccessful. We are so uncooperative and collaborative as one species. We don't regard ourselves, all 7.8 billion of us, as one species. Every adult I talk to, and I love some of y'all very, very, very much, but every single one of y'all been bullying me to get a job. If I could, I would. But what I have done in my limited time with my mold-altered brain is sort a new theory of everything from being human out using evolutionary logic. I do not understand why nobody is getting this. The centrality of life-centric thinking in solving our most intractable problems. I don't understand the grand chasm. I understand, to y'all's understanding, I understand it is complex. I make it so simple. I break it down. It's that you're in this linear, two-dimensional thinking. You're thinking to know what the words mean. Occasionally you get into 3D and there's some emotion behind it. But I am communicating not just in 4D, so that'd be categorically, that'd be, you know, I'm not gonna spend time trying to figure out how to tell you better, because I'm communicating in 5D, fully embodied, body, mind, and soul, subconscious, right here, right now, going entranced. I do it every day. I look for the deep vein of understanding. Why is there so much chronic disease? Why is there so much mental illness? Why is gender becoming so fluid? You didn't see that coming, did you? Why is gender becoming so fluid? Well, overall, we are so stressed as a species. Reproduction is basically not something that most of us see as a priority. And all of this is down to, in the context of the U.S. of hypocrisy, plantation capitalism. Now, basically, colonialization exported plantation capitalism everywhere. Unless a human in 2021 is living in a hunter-gatherer situation. Well, we got like 37 people. There are a few societies. Far-flung Pacific islands. Cases of extreme poverty. In developed nations. You know, communities. Compton not being one of them. Compton already implementing a UBI. That's advancement for your ass. Compton did better coronavirus than many of the surrounding communities. Compared at one point and got a screen print. Oh, just don't test me on the date. Beverly Hills was doing worse in coronavirus cases and deaths. And yeah, probably they all hold. Not a valid way of thinking. White people, you are always looking to prove the exception. You can't pause for 1 second and go, well, why is that? Look for the deeper reason why Black humans are being more successful in Africa. The least affected region in the world by COVID. We want to understand this so truthfully. Notice how I'm always monitoring my environment. And it happened back when I was in my back cave, supposedly fully in control of the environment. I am a human who has been living with chronic neglect for so long. The trauma is just natural. The trauma of never belonging. And so what do? I astutely migrate my ass to the only place I belong, Carnegie Mellon. Crickets. So now I'm thinking, well, who am I tell about this? There is abundance there. There are the people who can really help me do the research, the brainwave research. I need some funding to have the time to write this all out so it's not quite so 5D. I'll bring it down to 4 and 3D, not 2D. You are going to have to evolve into at least 3D. Communication-wise, you're not going to be able to keep listening just to go, I understand the words. Yes, I've understood the words. Yes, I understood the words. There's a level beyond that. I comprehend the concept. Level 2D is understanding. Level 3D is comprehending. Level 4D is starting to see the patterns. Starting to see the magnetic fields. All this is because of our concept of work. And our concept of the economy as money being scarce. Money can be as abundant as human life force. Back in the day, I'm from Puget Sound, thinking about the wide variety of not native, not indigenous, original peoples. They were Africans who went on rowabout. These concepts, native, indigenous, again, that's us in our English language, it's us in our... The original human inhabitants of North, Central, and South America were Africans who went on rowabout. They migrated. How fucking successfully did they develop rowboat technology? Because it wasn't just like one rowboat made it. How many people? And there's outriggers, you know. I mean, this technology, I have not personally ever been treated to understanding this. I had to come up with this in my own evolutionary logic way. But the original African civilizations colonized the globe by rowing. And then 500 years ago, the ocean sailing vessels that I have had some education on wiped all that motherfucking history, that crucial human lineage. They just took a match and burned. And this is millennia of our human history. Now we got all this separateness, got all this harm. Now I got internal storage. I still don't have electricity. Still don't have electricity. I'm having a bad bio day. Physiologically, my scalp is itching. As an adult educated in the U.S. hypocrisy, I'm like, I got to assess, how do I know that Dave Chappelle is in Yellow Springs? But then Deb, 5D, you can call me Zenzi, is like, Deb, you ain't got no other play right now but to occupy Yellow Springs. They'll see the Chappelle in you. Or you keep performing until somebody do. And we will modestly be like, Elaine first, please. Cause this is family. I mean, I'm an apprentice to you know, the family truth telling business. That's what I'm showing up to be. Dave shouldn't be taking on the whole fucking world himself. I'm here. I'm trying. I got the skills. I got the philosophy. Deb Helfrich, hashtag redheaded She-Hulk, saying, I'm 2021 She-Chappelle or bust.